I read your book, Atlas Shrugged, and I was wondering about the position that Eddie Willard was left in at the end of, or near the end of the book.
Oh.
And I was wondering how the Eddie Willards of the world, so to speak, would fit into your philosophy, rather than being left sitting on a railroad track in the desert.
I missed part of your question. You wonder what will happen to the Eddie Willards of the world?
Yes, I read the book, this part was left somewhat amiss to me because I see that, or I feel that there are probably more Eddie Willards in the world than there are Dagny Taggarts and John Galt, etc.
Yeah, and that's a very good question. Well, Eddie Willards in Atlas Shrugged is the symbol, in effect, the representative of the best among rational average men.
Yes,
that is, he's morally as good as the heroes, but he's not a genius. He's a man of average intelligence and a very scrupulous and high moral character. Eddie Willards is the first and the worst victim of any sort of dictatorship, statism, or collectivism. Eddie Willards can survive only in a free society, in a society where the Hank Reardons and the John Galt's and the Dagny Taggarts are free to function. He is at his best, and he carries his own weight, and he works productively in their kind of society.
Mm-hmm.
But he is too good to be able to survive or compromise with a collectivist state. In a collectivist state, he necessarily has to perish. He doesn't have the intellectual or spiritual resources to be fully independent and to vanish or to escape. He cannot stand on his own, but he cannot compromise with the evil around him, and therefore he perishes. The reason why I left him in that position is precisely to arouse the question which you asked. In other words, I wanted to tell the reader, here is the position of the best among average men.
Mm-hmm.
If the Dagny Taggarts or the Galts happen to come along, they will save him. If not, he will perish. But he cannot survive in a collectivist state. So that he doesn't die necessarily, but his question, his fate, in effect, is left to the reader. If you do not want him to perish, you better think over your ideas, check your premises, and advocate a free society. He needs it more than anyone else. As to the geniuses, they're self-sufficient. They'll escape anyway, but Eddie will perish.